Whoever wins this match becomes the grand winner.
Wow.
And what's more, the points are so tight. If Hashimoto wins, he will have the same points as Shaaban. Shaaban must win to take the crown automatically. If Hashimoto wins, they will have the same points, but the tie break would make Hashimoto the winner because he's had more gold medal wins.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. They have the same gold medal wins, they would, over the season, but Hashimoto would have more silver medals. So this is the tightest bout we are likely to see. Hashimoto must win to take the crown for the second consecutive time. Shaaban is not going to let him get away with that if he possibly can. Now Hashimoto asking his coach to put up the card, because that kick to the body, although Shaaban went down to the mat, Hashimoto threw in that roundhouse kick to the body. Watch for it. There's the kick to the back and to the side. Now, if you could see it from perhaps the other angle, here it is now. Once he goes down, it's still possible to kick to an opponent on the floor. And look, the kick.
Right to the side.
Right to the side. Now, the judges didn't go for the score. The coaches asked for the video review. Down goes Shaaban. In comes the kick to the body, there. Okay. What's your opinion, Ashley? There's the kick.
I'm just not a fan of the placement of it. I don't like that he's on the floor and he's kicking while he's on the ground. But let's see what the referees think.
Well, the thing is, if your body's on the floor, why can't you be attacked and why can't you be scored upon? Because if you were out in the street, what would happen?
It's true.
Exactly.
That's true.
And that's what the video review has revealed. It's a three-point score. Fantastic point. 3 points from Hashimoto Hiromu. And he'll have the century that goes with that. And there's another point for him as well. So you can see here the how important, isn't it, where the coach has the ability to show the card, but if the athlete thinks there's a score, he can ask the coach to do so as well.
Right. I see such clean techniques from Japan.
You see he's wearing the gold embroidery on his shoulders. That signifies he is the current grand winner. And if things go the way he seems to be taking them at the moment, he could well be taking it again. Mind you, it's never over until it's over. 2:17. You're the coach now of Shaaban. Put yourself in that chair. What are you going to tell him, Ashley?
I'm going to tell him to put pressure on him, and as he attacks, go for the head kick. Oh, that was perfect. He put pressure on him, and as he attacked, he went for a timing.
Perhaps he was listening to you. There's 1 point each, a Yuko, so it hasn't changed the situation drastically. 5 points to one. Hashimoto still leads, Hashimoto, in the blue color. See the difference in height between the two fighters. Again, Hashimoto goes for that punch to the head.
Kuwait will have to figure out his timing with the Japanese player, because he's very, he's always initiating.
This time Shaaban goes for that reverse punch. Again, he doesn't get the support of the judges or indeed his coach. Hashimoto receiving a yellow card for both going in with punches. And once more, Hashimoto looks over to the coach to put up the video review. No need for it though, because three of the judges agree it's a score. On the other hand, Shaaban is looking for a video review. So the question is Shaaban's punch, if it is good enough quality? Will it score? Is it first? Or is it at the same time? There's the punch from Hashimoto that has received the score. We're looking at the punch from Red. Now, is it the same time? It looks pretty close, doesn't it?
Mm-hmm.
And is it good enough to score? Does it ride up to the side of the face? What do you think, Ashley?
I would give it to him. Let's see. It's a, I would 50% give it to him.
So there's the punch. Hashimoto's got the flags. It hasn't been scored.
No.
It kind of hit the chest and rode up slightly. So perhaps it didn't have the form that would be... Video review team were looking for. No card left either for Shaaban as we close into the second half of the bout. You can see how much this means to Hashimoto Hiromu. He knows that if he gets that win, he will equal the scores of Shaaban. And he knows that if he gets that win, with his several medals, it will determine the outcome of the bout. One minute, 6 seconds still to go. Just to remind you, Abdullah Shaaban, if he wins, he would have 2,680 points. If Hashimoto wins, he would have 2,640 points. So that would give Shaaban the win. The second level of points is the minimum they can receive. If Hashimoto wins 2,640, that would give Abdullah Shaaban the same number of points, 2,640. But then it will go to the tiebreak countback, and that's where Hashimoto will become the grand winner for a second time. But Shaaban is not going to give this up easily. He's now got himself another point. And again, Hashimoto asking his coach to put the card up. No need though, as the judges have gone for the score. Moving into the last 30 seconds of the bout. Hashimoto is still leading 7-2. Shaaban desperately trying to find the range to be able to get a score in. Hashimoto's tactics are quite clever. He's standing in close. He's frustrating his opponent. He hasn't got any more options though. He's on 4 yellow cards. We're going to the last 15 seconds. He's standing close. There's a front hand punch from Shaaban. And there's a 1-point score from Shaaban. Two of the judges have gone for that. Once more, Hashimoto comes in close, stands his ground, throws in a punch. Shaaban still not able to get the distance. Hashimoto has done his job. 7-3, he takes the win. And he will take the gold medal and the grand winner crown for a second consecutive season.
Gold medal and still the very big grand winner, Hashimoto Hiromu from Japan, Sir Abdullah Shaaban.